This is a poem I wrote called Little Red. It's about the seasons and a little boy. Little Red liked summertime when his dad had a chance to take him on a climb. And his mother made sure she and Red got to swim and his sister stayed home to give the dog a trim. Little Red liked it when the weather was warm and he could dance around in a gentle summer storm. When the frogs on the logs would try to jump away, but one would get caught and come home to play. Little Red enjoyed picnic time, watching ants passing breadcrumbs down a long, long line. He liked stretching on the ground, looking all around and checking to see what his puppy had found. There were summer games and summer treats, even summer prickly heats. The sun stayed up late, and so did Red. But he was pretty tired by the time he reached his bed. Little Red loved summer noises, crickets chirping loud, the sound of far-off music and the singing of a crowd. Little Red enjoyed the fall, with leaves turning orange, red, and gold. He watched the children go off to school and wished that he could be that old. He wished he had a book bag and homework to do and a teacher to teach him all the things that were strange and hard. New. In the fall came Halloween. He could dress up silly or mean and visit friends and neighbors who would pass out treats and say, "What are you today?" And Thanksgiving was a special day for aunts, uncles, and cousins to come for turkey dinner. And they'd sit around and talk and say they weren't getting any thinner. Red liked to rake the leaves and pile them up high and take a running leap and at them almost fly. He'd hold them and examine all their beautiful designs and crinkle them between his hands and listen to their whines. In wintertime, the drifting snow landed on the world and turned it all aglow. It was like the icing on a cake. You could whip it into snowmen or eat a flying flake. While sister cared for skating and father skied with style, Red preferred a sleigh ride, and it always brought a smile. There were fires in the fireplace and boots to keep him warm, soups and steaming dinners to revive him from the storm. There was the quiet of the afternoon when the sun disappeared much too soon. The lights in all the windows and on the cars and poles and trains danced among the snowdrifts as if they knew a game. Little Red liked winter best, at least until spring came, and then he felt thankful that the snow had changed to rain. For soon the days grew longer, and the flowers peeked their heads, and heavy coats and scarves weren't draped on Little Red. Spring caused birds to show themselves and whistle up a tune. It made Red think of summer, that it would be coming soon. The days grew brighter, and there was more time to play. Could it be that hours had been added to the day? Trees that had been bare and dark turned green and ripe for climbing. Little Red's legs seemed longer, and the grass growing in the park had perfect timing. He chased squirrels, ran races, leaped brooks, and rode his trike. He helped with all the planting and with his sister took a hike. Springtime, summer, winter, fall, they each brought special joys. Springtime, summer, winter, fall were for special girls and boys.